Welcome back, folks, to Total Escape Games, Broomfield, Colorado. We are in the semifinals of the X-Wing Regionals. I'm John Stevens, joined in the booth by Alex Weinger. Thank you for joining us, Alex.
Thanks for having me.
Alex just got done losing to Dan Haar, sadly, in the quarterfinals of this event. Kyle's got a list we haven't seen yet, folks. Three next wings on the table. We're going to have Alex take us down top to bottom here. Let's talk about what's on these X-Wings.
All right, so three T-70 X-Wings. We've got Poe Dameron. It's the PS-8 Poe, and so he's adaptability up to 9. He's got the pattern analyzer, R5P9, which, if we all remember, is the droid that at the end of combat, if you still have your focus, you can regen a shield. Nian Num, he is got Snapshot and the Stress Hog, R3A2. And Integrated Estimate, of course. And he's actually the one in Black 1, which is strange because you'd think Poe would be running Black 1, as in the movies. Just Pava, she does not come with an EPT, so she has R2-D6, which allows you to get an EPT. So she puts Snapshot on there and, of course, Integrated Astromech.
All right. That is Kyle on the right-hand side flying those three next wings. So you just played Dan. We've seen Dan on the camera earlier today. Talk about the strategy Dan has coming into this game.
Okay, well, Dan is... he's basically got a hammer and a finesse ship. So Corrin Horn is the hammer. He's going to maneuver Corrin to get a good double tap on one of these X-Wings and try to take it right out. Miranda is going to try to dance around, stay out of arcs, drop her Connor nets, her bombs. She's also got a homing missile. That's going to be pretty effective. So a lot of dancing is going to be going on there.
So if you were watching us, I believe it was round 6. Dan Haar's won his win and in game. We talked a lot about cleaning the table in that game. Both of those ships have a built-in way to regenerate shields. So if you let them fly away, you're going to have problems here. If you're Kyle here today, which one are you going for first?
Whichever one you can nail down, which... it's hard because Corrin does have push the limit and he's got engine upgrade. So, you know, he's got multiple actions. But I think Corrin Horn is the one you want to get first.
Okay. Let's see here if that's the way they go. First round of movement has occurred. We put some tokens on the table, but these players started off in the opposite corners. Nothing has happened. They've now picked up those tokens and we are back to dials in round 2 of the semifinals, or turn 2 of these semifinals. On the other end of the room, John Grasser is playing, whoever won the last round you watched. Ryan won the last round you watched. So Ryan and John Grasser are playing for the other spot in these finals. There's a long, it looked like a 5. And we're going to boost to the right here.
Yeah, Ryan was my only other loss also, so it was nice to know that I lost to the top players.
Yeah. It's always a good feeling when your losses are to the guys who are the top of the heap.
So it looks like Kyle is pretty much staying in formation, a couple of straight maneuvers, and then boosting to the right.
So is there an advantage here to him staying in formation like this?
Well, the way to take down Dan's ships are focus fire. I mean, that goes with anything, but it really... is true for the ones that have the regen. And so you really want, if you can get them in arc, you want to focus them down.
And so far we're seeing Dan moving Corrin towards that left side. We've got Miranda coming down the middle of the screen here. Do you think that he's going to let him isolate these two, or will he bring them back together in the next couple of turns?
Well, Kyle has... he's going to come up with two choices here. He can either go straight or turn slightly to the right to maybe go for Corrin, or he can do a hard turn to try to get some shots on Miranda. But to anybody's guess who that is.
If you've never had the misfortune of playing a game of X-Wing with Dan, you don't have him in your ear like I do right now. He likes to table talk.
Yes, he does. He will table talk. He will trash talk. He will get under your skin. It is definitely a good strategy.
There's Jess with a move forward and a boost following it. You're going to see Poe moving last here. Oh, and that's Poe that just moved. Look at this. I've got things backwards on my screen here. So Poe moves there and boosts. Poe's going to be the only thing that moves after Corrin and Miranda.
Right, and that's the one that you might see make break formation first if there is a good shot or a good angle that Poe can read.
So dials are down for all five ships here. Believe we're on turn four at this point. I am John Stevens, joined by Alex Weinger. You're at Total Escape Games watching the Back to Dials production of the X-Wing Regionals. This is the semifinals here, folks.
So that looks like a four or five.
Yeah, it's a long move from Jess. Jess is boosting to the right here. We could see our first combat here. Got to see where Nine Num goes. And it really depends on where Miranda goes. We could see Miranda finally start firing those TLTs this round. Nine Num with a four straight. Nien Num. What is the accepted X-Wing way to say this?
I believe it's Nien Num.
Nien Num. I've had to repeat Alex's last name to him 17 or 18 times to make sure I had that right. Let's see if I can screw up Nien Num a couple of times as well. There is Num with long move forward and a boost to the right. Right now, the underneath that obnoxious red flannel arm of Daniel Haar's. Miranda moves towards those X-Wings and attempts to take a target lock on Nien out of range. I'm going to slam here now.
Yeah, this is one of the slams that you rarely see. It's the one slam. Usually you see them do a two move and then slam or a three move. Very rarely do you do the one.
But the one and a target lock here.
That's why he really wanted that target lock on Nien Num.
Why is that target lock important in a turn where he won't be attacking?
Well, you're going to need it for the homing missile, and it looks like that's probably one he wants to get off. Plus, it'll also help you if eventually you do a TLT shot to push through that damage. They are only two T-70s, so they do have just two green dice on defense.
So Corrin Horn with a short little one move forward. Corrin has pushed the limit. We'll see if Dan has any interest in pushing the limit here. Could we see boost barrel roll in the first round of combat at Corrin?
No, it looks like we're going to barrel roll. I was going to say boost barrel roll for him would be bad because he's going to probably take a lot of shots this round, and he wants to be defensive.
And Poe Dameron's the last one to move here. Goes straight for. They're checking to see if a boost fits here. They got to get a finger on Nien Num here. And it does not fit. So they push it back. It's not a legal boost. If you're new to X-Wing, you're not allowed to make an illegal action. So if you can't finish that boost, you can't make that boost. So what's the right answer for Poe without that boost?
The right answer for Poe is always focus. His ability is amazing with focus, and he has R5P9. If he takes some damage, he can regen a shield.
Poe settles on a target lock on Miranda.
And he didn't take the focus this turn because Miranda slammed, so she has weapons disabled, and Corrin is obviously out of range.
So we are done, and the players go, as we like to say around here at the Back to Dials podcast, back to dials. We're going to see some combat finally. What are you looking for this round, Alex?
Okay, so for Dan, he needs to get Corrin so he's not taking all three T-70s. And then if it's favorable, he's going to want to try his double tap, which is Corrin's specialty. Miranda will probably just try to stay out of arc, probably TLT. I don't think she's in a good position to maneuver to get any bombs or anything like that off.
Maybe look for Miranda to do a slight bank to pilot left here towards the middle of the screen?
Yeah, that's what I think.
Is it advantageous for Dan at all to bring Corn into the fight, or is his answer a long bank away from them? And if they shoot, make them shoot at range three.
Well, I mean, three X-Wings is a lot of firepower, so it just depends on how aggressive he wants to get. If he can maneuver so that he's only taking one or two and not all three, that would be ideal.
So if you were here for round six, you saw Dan play a game that was not at all aggressive. How did he play this against you?
Well, I was playing Commonwealth Defenders, and that matchup is really not good for me.
And that's, Dan said that. He brought this to play Commonwealth Defenders. He said he didn't see him until the top eight.
Yeah. Yeah, with Miranda's slamming and multiple bombs, it's just a nightmare.
Short move from Jess and a focus token. Long bank maneuver from Mean Numb.
Yeah, and that's just to stay in formation. If you do a two with the forward X-Wing and then a three, they stay in formation.
A little geography, or a little geometry lesson there.
Right.
Ultimately, this is a game of geometry.
It looks like Kyle thinks that he has Corrin somewhere in that area, those arcs. So he really wants
to. Yeah. And here's Miranda with that bank maneuver to the left, like we expected.
As expected, yeah. She's going to have, if she doesn't, well, you know, the way she's angled, no, I don't think that Connor net's going to fit. So I think she's just going to stay there and work on some TLTs.
So she'll take a focus token, would be the expert. And there's focus token. Yep. And Corrin, what'd we get?
defensive.
There's that long bank maneuver. Get far away from those two next wings.
Corrin is powerful, but he can die quickly if focused down, and that's a big chunk of your list.
We get a boost after that three bank maneuver.
Yeah, that'll put him, it looks like, range three of Neum Num, maybe out of range of Jess, and we'll see what Poe does.
And it's hard to tell on this top-down camera sometimes, but I would agree, Jess isn't going to get a shot here. Dan may have put Miranda in the sixth spot behind all three of those X-Wings, which is real good for him, I think.
Yeah, now he's got both the focus and the target lock on Neum Num, so that's going to be some good TLT shots.
There's Poe with a three bank to the right. We'll see what Poe's action is here.
I'm going to guess he's going to boost to the right as well to stay in formation with those other X-Wings. No, he opts with the focus instead.
He opts for the focus token. Yes, he does. Players are measuring closest point here to figure out whether or not this is obstructed. We're talking about shortest point here. The two players are wandering through a whole slew of templates here, looking for a good way to measure it.
While they're measuring, I misspoke. I said that the boost with Poe was the right move, but if he doesn't focus there, Miranda could say, you know what, Poe's open, let's TLT over there, so better safe than sorry. Poe is the real closer on the list.
Dan will now move those to the box so we can see what's happening. We have a hit and a crit. And Kyle rolls all blanks. So a shield comes off a Neum Num there. Goes to two shields now. Second TLT. Two hits there. Two evades. They'll avoid the second TLT shot. How big a deal is that?
Well, with TLTs, it's really incremental. It's slow but steady. So if you can get a couple of those evades, you know, your ship lasts a little longer. You can get a couple more shots in. So it is really important.
So Neum Num with the stress bot here sends a second stress onto Corrin Horn. Hitting and a crit in the box. A whole bunch of eyeballs. This will be the only attack coming at Corrin, so Corrin focuses. Corrin now has two stresses on him.
Yeah, that's not good, because No, those X-Wings are going to be able to run him down probably because he won't be able to do any push the limit, won't be able to take an action. That problem is that little mustache is going to block Nia Numb a little bit from really chasing him down.
Uh-huh. It's in that path there. But a lot of green maneuvers on an E-Wing dial. It's part of the reason that Dan and I have both been in love with them since they came out. It's pretty easy to shed the stress. It's whether or not he can avoid getting more now.
Right, right.
So we have dials down for Corrin and Miranda, waiting on Kyle's dials. Where do you expect these X-Wings to go, Alex?
So I really expect Jess to do a three bank towards Corrin. Nia Numb, he might try a one bank.
And Nia, of course, is wearing a stress now, too.
Yeah, he's not really in a good position to do anything. He'd be lucky to get a range three on Corrin. Poe, I expect probably a three turn from Poe.
All of our dials are down. Jess Pava starts us off, moving four forward here.
Oh, okay.
It's an aggressive move, it looks like.
Well, if Corrin did anything to turn to the right... Okay, there you go.
Yeah. The boost
that'll
action.
Fix that.
No matter how far Corrin moved here, I expect we're going to get that range three from Jess.
Yep.
Nia Numb with a short little one bank. That clears the stress.
And more importantly, it allows him a clear path to go forward. Oh, he's going to try to boost.
He's going to try to boost here. Gets around that. Is that a tiny, tiny little asteroid?
It's what's known as the mustache. It's one of the smallest asteroids, and it's hit the most. Just because people underestimate its size, and they always seem to hit the thing.
Miranda going left here.
Is she going to clip that?
Yep, she did clip it. There's a stress token on Miranda. No crit, though. Okay. Corrin Horn with a two bank. That, I don't think, breaks out of Nia Numb's arc.
No, and since she still has the, since he still has the stress, not going to be able to do anything. So that's two arcs of X-Wings.
Here goes Poe on a three bank to the right. And action time. Kyle says, hey, guys. Waiting on actions from Poe. Going to boost Poe one forward. Straight ahead there.
One forward. Yeah, he's thinking long term. He doesn't want to get caught up with that mustache having a problem like me and Nia Numb almost did.
So Poe has no shot here. Miranda. TLT's at Nia Numb.
Keeps pushing that slow and steady damage to Nia Numb.
First attack from Nia Numb. One hit. One evade. Second attack on those TLTs. Three hits.
That's a nice roll.
Nia Numb loses a shield, drops to one shield. Still three hull on there. You look at the board, you think those X-Wings are in better shape, but they're also the only ones that have taken damage.
Yeah. And they have no way to regen like the other guys do. Well, let's see. Yeah, Poe is the only real regen on the list, so...
Nia Numb blanked on the attack, but does put a second stress back on Corrin Horn.
So they're measuring because Jess gets rerolls for every friendly ship within range one. So...
Not within range one. That range ruler fits between the two bases.
Right.
Two crits. Doesn't matter. Three natural evades from Daniel Haars there. And they still haven't hit Corrin. They're chasing Corrin around and not doing anything.
And he's got the double stress, so even if he does a green maneuver, he's not getting his actions. He's not getting tokens, so...
And Miranda needs to stay in position, I think, to keep doing this, right?
Yeah. No. I think Dan is playing it pretty well. I mean, it's... Obviously, with the stress aug, it's tough to get out of those arcs, but He's just got to keep running and keep whittling away with Miranda.
And the stream's not yet updated. Neen Num did lose a second shield. They're going to one shield. Two banks are green. The player's confirming the dial on the E-Wing. So how do you feel about those being public now? There used to be you had to know these things. You had to memorize these dials.
Well, true. I mean, it's always been a friendly game, X-Wing. So if you asked, people would pretty much tell you. But then I think they changed it so everything was open knowledge, you know, anything that should be. So I guess there were a few maybe bad apples in X-Wing that didn't want to share their information. So they had to put it in the rules.
That is a three bank to the right from Jess to start off this round. Not boosting, because it'll run into Corrin. Focus token, though.
Still pretty aggressive, because you have a little problem for that debris field there on her next move, depending.
It's a hard two from Neen Num. It's going to have Corrin Horn again. Like, going to take one stress off and put one on, it looks like.
Yeah, unless Dan does something wily, like do a left turn, which looks like he didn't do. So, yeah, they're going to get at least two shots at him.
Yep, they're going to get two shots at him. He's going to get a stress token. He'll take one off here. He'll get it back when Neen Num fires. Miranda with the little bank maneuver there.
Yeah, Kyle definitely has a good strategy against Corrin, but he just needs to get some damage through.
If Neen Num leaves this table and the stress hog goes away before Corrin at this point, I feel like that puts him in a bad spot.
Yeah, absolutely. Then he's got a real uphill battle. The path to success for him is very cloudy at that point.
So Poe Dameron with a long bank, followed by a boost. If you can see my monitor, it's covered in post-it notes, so I know which next wing is which.
I think Kyle is comfortable boosting now because he's really trying to push the damage through to
me. So this is a third attack. Poe is in range.
Oh, he got the range. Okay, that's good. All right, well, he's got no focus, but should be interesting. It's going to be these natural die rolls.
Poe range 3 to Corrin. And we're bumping things.
Yep, it happens after, 8 rounds?
We are trying to figure out if it's obstructed or not. It is not obstructed. So range 3, Corrin still gets 4 green dice here. One hit from Poe.
That's unfortunate if we're a fan of Kyle.
3 evades from Corrin Horn there, folks.
Yeah, Dan's defense dice have been spot on.
Yes, they have been. Miranda at Neen again with the homing missiles. Oh, that's 5 hits in the box.
That may be a dead Neen Num unless he rolls really well. Is that just 1?
3 and a crit.
I think that's a dead Neen Num. He's got integrated.
Pitch the integrated astromech. Yep. He takes a total of 3 damage there, so that's shield, hull, integrated astromech, leaving him at 2, I think.
I think, yeah, it might be.
Neen's at 1.
1 hull, yeah.
And no more astromech, okay. Oh no, 1 hit on the attack from Neen Num.
This is not going well for Kyle at all.
Daniel Haar still has all of his red dice in the box, crowding the box a little. Evades from Corrin.
Yeah, and now Neen Num doesn't have his stress hog anymore, so...
Yeah, that stress hog is gone. Next turn, Corrin will clear stress. I don't think the hog put one on this turn.
You know, that might be an error on his part, because it should have. So, like I said, after 8 rounds, people get tired, they forget things.
It is a long day. Is that a voluntary trigger?
Yes, yes.
You have to go back and fix those.
Right, that's correct.
Hit, crit, 2 evades. Oh my. Corrin Horn is dodgy today.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Oh, he finally hits him.
Did we get some damage through?
Jespava finally pushes a damage through. Korn loses a shield. It doesn't matter.
It's not going to matter because he's going to do a green maneuver, clear the stress, regen the shield with R2-D2, and then have actions and tokens and...
Oh, and no, there is no stress there because he pitched the astromech at 8.
That's right, and that happened before because Miranda is a higher pilot skill.
That's why there's not a second stress. So Kornhorn's going to clear the only stress, get back the shield, have access to push the limit next turn.
Yep.
And I don't know how Neen Num even stays alive next turn. Miranda's TLTs give her plenty of places to shoot at. There's that piece of debris in front of Neen Num. I can't see it going left to get away.
No. Maybe the best hope for Neen Num is if he can get into range one of Miranda, somehow evade her turret, her main turret.
Which is only 2 dice?
2 dice, but at range one, it'll be three.
Yep.
And she hasn't been hit, so she could take a shield down and roll 4 dice.
Yep.
And it looks like she still has a target lock on him, so I just don't see Neen Num lasting past this round.
Did she not have to spend the target lock on the homing missiles?
I think you just have to have the target lock, if I'm not mistaken. But I'll probably get flamed in chat if I got that wrong.
And the chat channel has pointed out to us that, yes, the same thing we were realizing, the integrated astromech had already been ejected before that attack.
Yeah, the chat people are on top of their game usually, and if you make one mistake, they will let you know.
That's okay. I've made a lot of them. That's why I don't pay attention to the chat. We are holding dials here. Miranda's dial and Korin's dial. Korin's dial, it appears, is down. It's that yellow wrapped dial near the top of your screen. Dan hasn't made a decision here with Miranda. Where do you think Miranda's headed, Alex?
Well, two options. You can either go straight and get that turret, main turret shot on Neen Num, or, you know, you might just... I just don't see a turn right. It'd be...
Jespava goes YOLO right over the debris and runs into Kornhorn. We'll get a stress for the debris. We won't get an action. Hit, not a crit, so nothing happens. Neen Num with a bank one to the right towards Miranda.
Yeah, but he needed to do that. He didn't want it to go over the debris again and to get another stress.
Yep.
And he wanted an action, maybe try to survive with the focus token. So
that maneuver does clear the stress and pick up a focus token. Hard two from Miranda, trying to get out of range one. He would much rather TLT here, I think, than the regular one.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. That's two cracks at the apple, so
Yep, he's going to get two cracks at it here with Neen Num only needing to get hit by one of them. Takes a focus token there. Daniel Harris has a tendency to leave tokens laying all over the place. There's a target lock in the middle, not attached to anything anymore. Korin goes focus and evade and regains the shield. So Corrin's back to 3 shields already. Korin loses the stress token on the green maneuver, gets it back on the push to limit. Again, that stress token is 16 inches away from Korin for some reason.
And that's interesting. I don't know if you caught that, but when Korin moved, he actually checked range to Jess illegally because I didn't see him take a target lock. So
Dan didn't check it. Kyle did.
Oh, okay.
I don't know what the purpose was, but it was Kyle who put a hand out there to check range. Two hits there from Poe. Miranda takes her first damage there. Miranda should be down to 3 shields. Korin should be back up to 3 shields from R2-D2. Kyle's on it in the booth, and we are correct on your screen again. TLT's at Neen Num here. There's a focus.
That should be enough, because he's only got 2 defense dice, so...
With only 2 defense dice, Neen Num is... gone from your table, folks. Second shot does happen. It has been confirmed by judges here. So he can now take an extra dice and shoot this TLT at nothing to get a shield back.
That's right.
So Miranda goes back to four. TLTs on Miranda are dirty.
And just like that, they took some shields and they've regened them all back.
So Jess hits Corrin twice.
Corrin evades twice.
Oh my gosh, Corrin's evade dice are the single most MVP in this entire game.
Measurement was for snapshot, according to the channel. Yes.
Ah.
Jess Pava has snapshot.
Very good.
We are back to dials here. Corrinhorn loses those tokens. Corrinhorn should have one of the stress tokens that are floating near the top of your map, but it's far away for some reason.
And as stated, Dan likes to throw his tokens and they end up a long way from his ships.
Kyle pointing out to the players that they've got tokens everywhere, and we kind of have them in the vicinity of the ship now.
But we know that Corrin did do push the limit, so he does have that stress.
He does have that stress. We haven't caught up on your screen yet, but Nian Num is dead. Where does that leave Kyle?
Very little hope. I mean, well, there's always hope in X-Wing, but full Corrin and Miranda, she still has one homing missile. She's still got the Connor nets, the bombs. Corrin is full health with his amazing
dice. They both are.
I just don't see a path for... There's just no path for victory. You have to get incredibly lucky.
Miranda puts down the ion bomb here.
And that's pretty good anticipation. I mean, Poe has to go through there.
Unless he wants to get involved.
Unless he breaks off, in which case I just can't see that happening because he's so far behind.
And breaking off here is, you can't do it. You're not involved here. Every round that Poe doesn't shoot at anything, Kyle falls further behind here.
And with Sabine, it's going to be two damage, not one, if it hits him.
Focus on Miranda. We're still waiting on Kyle to catch up with the Nian Num death. Corrin goes forward.
It was a three forward, green maneuver?
Yep. Didn't matter. He didn't have a shield to regain there.
Right.
But green maneuver clears the stress, push the limit for focus and evade, puts the stress back on. Here comes Poe right at that ion token.
Okay, so...
I don't think he can get out of it.
No, a barrel roll will work here. The...
barrel roll will get him out. You are correct. That moves him two away from... Oh, he focused instead.
Well, no, the only problem is the astromech droid that came with Poe, which was BB-8... is the way that he can do the barrel roll.
The ion pops. So the ion does one damage. Sabine causes one damage. The ion does none itself.
Right.
So Poe loses his first shield. So Poe's down to two shields. We seem to have lost the tech booth.
Looks like Poe might actually get some damage here. Or push through some damage, I should say.
Poe... We're not sure if Poe pushed through damage there or not.
Checking to see if Jess got any rerolls or not.
Yep. One hit there. One evade from Jess. And no damage on the TLT attack there. We have lost track of Kyle. Nian Num is dead. Poe actually only has two shields. We're not sure exactly what Miranda did there. I think Miranda lost one. Corrin takes two, it looks like, on that attack from Jess.
Yeah, two shields.
Down to one shield on Corrinhorn.
But he...
He'll get it back.
Yeah, he'll get it back. If that was truly, he had tokens, so he could have spent those tokens on that shot from Jess, unless...
It's fully possible he did and then didn't remove them.
Right.
The Dan Harris shortcut. Kyle, if we could remind the players to empty the dice box. So, Jess on the right-hand side, pilot skill 3, still full health. Poe on the left-hand side, in the middle of the board there, has lost a shield to that Ion token and Sabine. We know what Poe's doing this turn, going forward one.
Has to. Ionized, he'll still get an action. But yeah, one forward, white maneuver, so...
Yep. So a long forward move from Jess there.
Really wanting to get a good range on Corrin for this next coming shot.
And Jess took a focus token. Oh, the other ion bomb comes down. It's going to catch Jess. Poe's already ionized. It's going to go a one white forward. I don't think it'll get Poe.
Yeah, it's tough to tell from our screen here, but I think Poe's going to be just out of range one of the ion bomb.
So after that ion bomb drops, we reveal a maneuver template. Or dial, I guess. Hard turn to the right. That'll give Miranda some TLT shots at something.
It's possible she chooses to slam here, not wanting to take some shots from Jess, but odds are she's just going to pour on the TLT.
I think if I'm her, I sit here and yeah. Focus.
Yeah.
Corrin's going to two-bank right into the front of Jess. We'll probably see another snapshot measurement.
And this one he should have.
This one he should have.
And that goes before tokens go down, so... That's one hit.
One hit on the snapshot. One evade right next to it in the dice box.
You know, when the green dice are on, you just can't beat the list.
When he's got green dice and like this and he's regenerating, it's an inevitable march is all it is. Corrin cleared the stress token and regained a shield on the green maneuver, so Corrin goes back to two. Boost barrel roll will get him out of range one. We'll see if he tries the barrel roll. Maybe it's boost focus here.
Yeah, he could have barrel rolled and then boosted out of Jess's arc, but you don't... I mean, Poe going one forward, it still might have clipped him, and he would have had no tokens. It would have had the asteroid in the way, but clearly he thought better of it.
We've seen one movement here, or one action. He's going to push the limit for a focus token there. Poe going one forward. It'll clear an ion token.
And he was reaching for his die. I can't tell you how many times I've been ioned, and I reach for my die. I'm like, nope, I'm ioned. It's just a one forward.
Poe still gets an action here. Poe does have an arc on Corrin Horn here. Kyle's looking at the table trying to figure out who's going to get hit by this ion token. Poe's right on the border. You can't boost Poe here.
No, it's got to be a focus. It has to be a focus.
A boost, maybe in any direction, guarantees Poe another ion.
Yeah. I mean, if Poe had pushed the limit, he could boost and then focus. But
he's going to boost into the ion token.
He might be thinking, you know what, he just has to push through damage at this point. He can regen it later, I'm assuming. So that focus token is actually on Jess, not Poe, correct?
Correct. So that's the ion token coming back on Poe.
Yep, and we'll need another one
for Poe and Jess, both.
Now,
and Jess takes that damage, so okay. Jess goes to two shields. They both get ion tokens. Poe does get a range 2 attack at Corrin instead of range 3. Okay. Nothing happens in that attack, though. Miranda attacks Jess and focuses. So there's the first shot on Jess on the TLT. Nada on the second. Jess loses another shield. Oh, he switched targets to Miranda. He's... Jess at Miranda here.
Okay. I don't know what to say on that one.
you got to pick a target.
Yeah.
We harped on it in round six. You got to kill one of these ships. You can't bounce back and forth.
Yeah, and Korn's token was stripped, right? So, yeah, I just don't...
Miranda lost a shield there, goes to two shields. Miranda's going to get to TLT next turn and get him back. Like,
yep.
Dan's in a fantastic spot here. We know right where Poe and Jess are going.
Like, well, now Miranda's at zero shields.
Yep.
So she can regen one, and then if Kyle can focus on her, maybe get some crits, maybe some lasting effects that are detrimental, maybe that's what he's thinking.
Next turn, he's not shooting at anything, though, is he? I mean, Dan has to be asleep for Poe and Justin.
That's true, because they're only, yeah.
They're going one white forward here.
So, regen one shield with Miranda this turn, and then one the next turn.
So, no boost from Jess. She could boost straight, but not to the right. Takes a focus token. I don't think she'll have a target.
No, that's purely defensive there. All the boosting and barrel rolling and... from Korin, and Miranda will be able to slam if there was an arc. There was just going to be no shot, so that focus is defensive.
Hard right from Miranda. I expect a focus token, yes?
Yeah.
Focus token. Korin, two bank, clear stress. Korin regains that third shield again.
Looks like he's got out of Justice Arc. But Poe, with the one forward, might still have him, so he may choose to boost here.
He's going to bank boost to the right. He still has a second action to push the limit with if he desires.
But he really doesn't need it. He's not taking any shots, so why add the stress? That opens up his dial, and he can do a lot of good stuff.
Yep. But Korin did regain his third shield in that round.
Remember, Korin has not been able to shoot.
No. Korin hasn't fired the whole game.
Yeah, because Miranda has the stress. Everything. So I think he didn't take that stress so he can actually K-turn and actually get some shots at these guys.
Poe moves the one white forward from the Ion token. A boost here will put... We'll give Poe some shots. Poe's got options here.
I mean, the real problem... Well,
maybe he doesn't have options. He has Korin.
Right. The real problem for Kyle is his unmodified attack die rolls have not been great, and Korin's have been stellar.
Yes. Two hit. Two evade.
I mean, what do you say?
Kyle just exclaimed, Jesus, in the room. And that's it, right?
Yeah. You know, the saying goes, it's better to be lucky and good. Well, right now, Dan is both.
Yep. When you're lucky and good, you're unbeatable.
Yep.
They are looking to see if that attack on Jess is a obstructed one.
From our monitor here, it almost looks like they're parallel, in which case the attacker gets to choose what points it goes from.
They both look slightly crooked to me.
Yeah.
I would guess that from here they are parallel, but it's hard to tell. We're on a camera that's 8 feet above the table. On camera, they appear to be parallel. And in the case of parallel, the attacker picks the points. Just one. Jess with the reroll. Jess has a focus token still. Do you focus to evade this one?
Yes, because negate the damage that you can negate.
They negate, and that's how he goes. Only two dice as Miranda regains a shield. Only one hit, one evade. No damage there. So those Ion tokens didn't end up killing Kyle. But nothing happened either. Poe attacked Corrin. Corrin naturally evaded everything.
Well, this turn's going to be really interesting because Jess is kind of in a precarious position. Their turns, she needs to do a wide turn to clear Poe. But Corrin could just... Well, I really think Corrin's going to do the K-turn so he can actually get some guns in the fight.
And a K-turn here would... allow the double tap on Poe. The way the dice are going, it doesn't seem likely that Poe can kill Corrin in one shot.
Right.
We like to say there's always direct hit around here. Right. But.
And, I mean, even if he K-turns and has a stress, the first shot is going to be unmodified, but he'll get a target lock with fire control, and then the second shot, if he chooses a double tap, should be pretty good modify.
Dials are down for Kyle here this round. Dan still playing with that dial for Miranda. Miranda's making a hard right here, yes?
I don't see any other move for her.
So we are starting with Jess Pava. We're double checking Poe.
A three turn would clear.
Talon roll, I think is what he just called.
Oh.
That is a talon roll from Jess.
And that's smart because the three was going to be close to hitting Poe.
Yep.
But with the talon roll, you can actually slide it along the edge.
You get to play with where they're at on there. Oh, not the hard turn. The bank from Miranda. Creates a little more space between Miranda and Jess. Miranda takes a focus token.
I'm thinking Dan did not anticipate that talon roll, but neither did I. That was a great, great move.
But you anticipated this one. You called this one. It is the K turn from Corrin Horn. He'll pick up some stress here. It's the perfect time to do it. He's going to get him into combat, I think, and he's not missing out on a shield regeneration.
No.
And Poe Dameron hard two to the right. We're going to get a little round of jousting from the two of them. Range two. Who does it favor?
It's going to favor Corrin if he chooses to double tap, I believe. Because Poe does not have any reroll ability if he takes the focus, which I think he should.
Rilesman, I'm going to have Kyle take a photo, and he's going to post that photo on the Back to Dials Facebook page. You can see where the players are playing at. It is a custom-built rig we designed last year for the regionals event. Two hits from Poe. No evades from Corrin.
Which is okay because he was at full, and so he'll be able to do okay. And Jess is not in arc, so he's only taking that one. He'll be able to regen those.
Yes. Checking range to Jess here. It is barely in range 3. Would you take that attack?
Yeah, because Jess doesn't have the regeneration that Poe does. If you think Poe for a couple, he'll just get it back. But Jess, once it's damage, it's damage.
And good dice here could
Well, he's had good dice so far, being so...
done, yeah. Two hits there. Reroll one. Get one evade. The last shield comes off Jess Pava.
Yeah,
TLT's from Miranda now. First one is two hits. Jess gets to pick up and reroll. Gets two evades. No damage on the first TLT
shot. There's a slight mistake. He should have been able to get a target lock from Corrin to Jess. I didn't see it down there. Maybe he did it. I'm not sure.
Nothing. The TLTs miss. But Miranda did... Ooh.
Finally, a decent roll from Kyle.
Miranda got a shield back and has two now. That is hit, crit, crit on Miranda. Two natural evades.
Oh my god.
Those green dice of Dan Haar's, folks.
He's using some special dice from a couple years ago. he may not want to use the dice that he's won here today. He might want to keep using those dice yep. because they are clearly working for him.
And we, there were jokes just in the room that I get to hear and nobody else does about checking Dan's dice. Did Dan bring dice that are painted on all eight sides today? Kyle, did you get the message I had asked for? If you could get a picture of the rig.
So it looks like he did allow him to get that target lock, but he did not choose to double tap.
Yep. No, took the target lock, did not double tap. I'm okay with that. The range 3 attack double tap seems a little sloppy to me.
Yeah, I mean, because both TLT shots didn't push anything through Jess, but I guess from my perspective, it would have been somewhat of a missed opportunity. Whether you let him take that target lock or not, he did some other firing. So, but Kyle was kind about it and said okay.
So Jess moves, still has that target lock from Corrin. I'm expecting something really short from Corrin here.
Yeah, you know, he took some damage, so he's going to want to regen the shields. He's going to do a green maneuver.
Jess boosted there.
And Jess is, you know, Kyle's anticipating that to get possibly a range one shot or maybe a bump.
Oh, we're going to see where this slides to here. Okay, plenty of space there. This could be really bad for Jess Papa.
Yes, yes. But provided that Jess lives through this, it could be bad for Corrin.
Yes.
If he did a one forward or something forward with Poda bump.
So Corrin got a shield back there. Corrin goes to two shields. Dan is still debating actions here. What do you do here?
I mean, it would be nice to barrel roll out of Arc, but Miranda has shown that that's what he's going to do.
And here comes the barrel roll down that gets out of Jess's arc. We haven't had Poe move yet. His dial is still down there, right below Corrinhorn. Now, he also took himself out of Jess's arc.
Correct. I was going to say, he might not want to do that because Miranda's TLT shots have not pushed the damage through on Jess like they did in him numb. Nope. And but he's here, and I'm in the booth, so what do I know?
Poe trying to make a bank maneuver here.
Okay.
Might have been blocked by Jess. Nope. It's a two. No, it is a one he's holding, but it'll clear.
What he was hoping for was that Corrin would bump into Jess, and then that would cause Poe to bump into Jess and have a nice range one shot.
And then Poe, yes, exactly, gets that range one shot. Poe takes a target lock there.
And why is that important? Because then Corrin would have no tokens. But none of that happened, so it's going to be just Miranda's TLTs, it looks like.
Yep, the only combat this round is Miranda and the TLT. Three dice in this first attack. Three hits. Miranda will fire two dice here and regen a shield, go back to two. Nothing doing on that. So one TLT hit. I believe that was the first hull off Jess Pava, but we'll confirm that at the table.
Yeah, she's
so no shields left on Jess Pava. Yeah. Two hull left now.
And, of course, Miranda's now back up to two shields.
Yep.
So.
Nothing's happened, yeah. First dial down. Poe's dial is down.
I see Jess probably doing a K-turn.
Okay.
Otherwise, she's out of the fight. I mean, she could try to run and reset the positions, but with Miranda and her TLT shots, I would not want to be in Kyle's position.
No, me neither. Of course, I'm glad that I didn't have to play 8 games of X-Wing today, too. It is a long day. The day started for my employees at 7 a.m.
I was here. I was here.
Here we are at 10:06 p.m. in Denver. This is the Denver Regionals live from Total Escape Games in Broomfield, Colorado. I'm John Stevens. Giving you the play-by-play, I am joined by SoCal resident and long-distance traveler for this event, Alex Vianger.
And instead of the K-turn, it looks like she went with the
Talon roll. And I always forget about it. They have a similar effect to that K-turn and flipping you around.
They give you a little bit more options for positioning, so it is nice.
Miranda, the two-turn to the left there. Nothing in range.
Okay, well,
the left turn surprised me. I was expecting a right turn.
If you go too much in the corner, you get boxed in, and that's how Miranda can get killed. So you want to keep your options open, stay towards the middle. So I understand that. He's got time. He's got a supreme advantage here. So
he slammed and took a focus token.
Yeah.
Corrin Horn is going to make a bank maneuver there. That'll put a third shield back on Corrin. With Corrin back to three shields, nothing's happening for Kyle.
Yeah.
It's this slow, monotonous, one damage at a time off of one of those next wings.
Yeah. I mean, basically, how long are we into the game and no true permanent damage has been put on any of Dan's ships?
Yep.
But that is the power of the, you know, Rebel regen.
So Corrin made a green maneuver, then took a focus and evade. That earns a stress token on push to limit. Also earned him back that second shield. Poe Dameron is joining Jess in Talon Roll Town.
Yep. So we're going to shot some on Corrin, but they are not going to be great shots.
Poe has a target lock and a focus token. Dan spends the evade token, cancels out that damage. Jess at range 2 here. Ugh. Rerolls a hit. 2 evades. And Corrin Horn takes no damage. He got a shield back.
How many times have we said that? Corrin Horn takes no damage?
Takes no damage. Yeah, it is. Nothing has happened to Dan's ships. Miranda's gonna, I'm assuming, come back to the left a little. End up with some TLT shots, get another shield back.
Now, Corrin's in a little bit of a stress situation. He really wants to turn left, but that asteroid, unless he wants to go over it, which probably not, he's either going to have to try a little bit longer straight maneuver or, you know, bank to the right.
What's the longest green straight maneuver he has?
For Corrin? Longest green? I think it's 3.
So that's my guess.
It's been a while since I've played Corrin Horn, but making a bit of a resurgence.
Jess moves forward there. Too close to Corrin to boost anywhere. Focus token.
Looks like Kyle is joining Dan on the sloppy token play.
Yep.
Because he's still got his tokens out there.
So 3 forward from Corrin Horn. What's the blue and the red token in the middle of the table that aren't doing anything, guys?
Those were Corrin's. Blue one is his target lock, and the red is his stress, which it looks like he's pushing the limit to just regain.
Yep. So 3 forward, and then
then a focus
and evade. A 3 bank from Miranda. I expected the hard turn to close the distance. No target lock anywhere. Dan's going to be slamming here. Going to try that 3 bank. Can't slam. Going to hit an asteroid.
Actually, a slam is a maneuver, so...
Oh, okay.
It does... if you put it down, you have to finish the maneuver.
So
even
Dan
if, yeah,
slams into an asteroid.
I mean, he's not caring that he wasn't firing, because it was slam. He wasn't firing anyways.
And Miranda doesn't take any damage because Dan's dice like him. Two forward out of Poe Dameron there. Focus token and a range 3 attack on Cornhorn. Trying to decide if that rock is in the area.
Yeah, that should have cleared his stress, but I don't know if he still has the... Okay, he does have the target lock still. Yep.
This is range 3 obstructed, though, according to the players.
Okay.
Oh, crit, though. Lols.
Yeah. I laugh at your crit, what Corn says.
The way that Dan has rolled, you're like, crit. Oh, God, he's got 5 green dice. Like, yeah.
Dan really has to be concerned that he's using up all of his good dice rolls for this game.
Yep. Spend the evade token. Jess put 3 hits in the box and didn't do any damage.
Cornhorn takes no damage.
Yep.
Add one more to the...
I wish we'd started a tally at the beginning of the turn. Cornhorn takes no damage. Cornhorn takes no damage. Players have picked up their dials. We are planning out this next turn. Nobody's taken any damage in a while. Miranda was out wandering aimlessly, right, not doing anything. Where does Miranda go now?
Well, she has to be worried that both the X-Wings make a hard right turn if she makes a turn in. So
a hard left turn.
I'm sorry, hard
pilot
left. Yeah.
Left. Okay.
Yeah, so she might just do a straight maneuver here because she would still be in range if they did.
Do you care? If you're Dan flying Miranda, do you care if both those X-Wings turn in on her right now?
She's only got 2 shields. She'd regen a third. With a focus, she could take some... Well, the way it's going, probably not. But, you know, statistically, you know, it's going to happen sometime. Or maybe not. Who knows? Well, and there we go.
There is the hard left turn by Jess. Was going to clear that asteroid. We bumped it. We're still clearing the asteroid. Fly casual, folks. Yes. Fly casual. I really wish there was a way to force the asteroids to stick to things.
That would be nice. That would be nice. After 8 rounds, players get tired, their hands get shaky, and the other player knows that, and... Yeah.
Even the players now have... The players started rolling dice more than 13 hours ago.
Yeah, there's that straight maneuver. And he was wise to that.
Looks like Jess still, maybe? No.
That's what the slam's for.
Ah, oh, look.
When in doubt, slam out of arc. That is the cardinal rule for Miranda and pretty much any K-Wing with advanced slam.
So, Dan might remember a slam token there. Takes the target lock on the advanced slam.
Right, and there's the weapons disabled token.
Cornhorn with the 2 bank to the left. He's already got full shields, but that green maneuver clears stress. Get 2 actions here if you want them, do you?
Well, it looks like Jess doesn't have arc, so worst case, Poe's shooting you one time. I don't think so.
Take the focus token, call it a day for Dan there.
And then you're set up for the K turn next turn to get some guns on target.
Left turn from Poe.
Yeah. Kyle really wanted Miranda to turn in, and Dan was savvy.
It's a good description of Dan. He tends to be a pretty savvy X-Wing player. Oh, the boost towards Corrin. Mm-hmm. Poe will get a shot.
If you don't get the shot on Miranda, might as well boost and try some Corrin shots.
That is a target lock on Corrin, so we'll have a little dice modification.
He's range had that 2. For a while. He hadn't had to use it. So. Yep.
Range 2, Poe attacking Corrin here. Well, doesn't need it now. 3 yeah, hits. He takes 1 there. Cornhorn back down to 2 shields. He did it. Nope, he didn't do damage. That shield will be back in approximately 95 seconds. No other combat this turn. Jess is aimed in the wrong direction. Miranda slammed. Corrin's aimed in the wrong direction. Corrin's where we want to focus here right now. He's down to 2 shields. He'll get back to 3rd shield with a green maneuver. But does he want that here? Are you K-turning?
You know what? Being that Poe was so aggressive, I would continue being defensive with Corrin. Remember when I talked about at the beginning, Corrin was the hammer and Miranda was just the finesse ship.
Well, right now, at this point.
Yeah, right now it's Corrin being the carrot.
Yep.
And Miranda being the very big stick.
Yeah, and it's worked so far for Dan. They mark Poe's location so the Jess can make a 3 bank to the right here to start us off. Maybe setting up a snapshot. We'll see where Dan went.
I see Dan going a straight maneuver. Even a K-turn, yeah. That would be a very difficult snapshot to pull off.
Waiting on tokens for Jess.
Snapshot has not been too much of an issue this game.
Jess goes boost straight forward.
Okay, that might get some snapshot play there.
Dan starts with Miranda. A very slow left-handed bank there, followed by a slam again. Interesting. Did Dan not feel like he was going to get to Poe Dameron?
Probably not. I think since, you know, Kyle's ships were faced the wrong way. Oh, did we get a snapshot there?
We did get a snapshot.
And Corrin laughs it off. No, he was thinking that they would really try to chase Corrin down, so probably out of even TLT range. I expect a very long straight maneuver from Poe here.
I believe in that snapshot that Corrin gained a shield on a green maneuver and then lost it to the snapshot.
Okay.
They'll double check. Corrin either has 2 or 3 shields before combat here.
Oh, I thought I saw an evade one of his rolls, so...
He does go focus evade on the push to limit there, and a stress token finally comes flying across the table. Poe with the left bank.
Not what I anticipated, but he was probably covering all options because Corrin could have turned in and gotten out of Jess's arc, and then Poe would have been there. He's still going to have arc, it's just not going to be as good.
Yep. He set himself up where they're both going to get to shoot. We start off with Poe.
Right.
Who puts 2 hits in the box.
He still has that target lock.
Dan's like, he's an arc, and they're double-checking it. And Dan looks at it and says, yep, it's in. So 2 hits from Poe. Range 2.
I just don't understand why he's not using that target lock.
He's going to spend the target lock.
Here we go.
And then he's going to spend focus. 3 hits. Daniel having some problems with his dice. Spends his focus. Does not appear he took any damage. Kyle will double check that for us. We're not quite sure of Corrin's shield count right now.
Well, I think we should put another notch in the Corrin horn takes no damage.
Takes no damage, yep. Jess has no focus, gets the reroll. That's a 2nd hit. And some evades, and Cornhorn takes no damage.
Another 2 notches this round for Cornhorn takes no damage.
Miranda going on the long bank here, trying to finally get back in this.
It's possible. It's possible the long bank... Yeah... I'm thinking more along the lines of 3 turn in. You don't want to...
Risk that tiny asteroid.
Yeah, the tiny asteroids, they sneak up on you. It's like I said, the mustache. It's one of the smallest ones that gets hit the most.
So we start off with Jess here. A 3 bank that puts her in front of Cornhorn.
And unfortunately, she's tilted a little bit away. So if he just did a straight maneuver... She may not get that snapshot because no arc.
Yeah. Focus token on Jess there. It's a straight maneuver from Cornhorn 1. Puts the shield back on Corrin, of course. If he lost one last turn, we still never figured that out.
Now, if Poe dialed up a 3 bank, that would be
Gonna focus and evade here.
Okay, okay.
Take the push to limit again. Keep the stress token. Focus evade on Cornhorn, because he's expecting Poe to come up behind him here.
Oh, he did the two turn.
You called it.
Yeah.
Turn in, though. I think I would have gone three because...
Yeah, because if Poe does the three bank like we're expecting, it may be out of range again.
Well, he's slamming. Care. He's going to slam.
And the reason he's able to do this is because he's got plenty of time.
Yep.
None of his guys have taken any permanent damage, and it's just...
I don't actually know how much time he has. Kyle will let us know when he has a second how much time is left in this round. And maybe Kyle can send one of the numerous spectators to tell me if anybody has won the other semifinal. So John Grasser is through to the finals.
Oh, okay.
And there are 5 minutes left in the feature match.
Oh, no. He spends all his tokens and he takes no damage from four hits.
Yep. Four hits. Spend all the tokens. Laugh again. We're going to say it again. Go for it, Alex.
Cornhorn takes no damage. This was the one time of the entire match I could have sworn that he was going to take at least one damage.
Yep. Yeah. Well, there's only 5 minutes left in this game. We've only had one ship die.
Sometimes that's enough to win the match, though.
Yeah, it's 90 minutes of X-Wing, 90 minutes of flying around in circles. And Dan Harris is 5 minutes away from going to the finals, having taken out one ship here in the semis. John Grasser, who we had host the sixth round with us. This was his 17th regionals event and his 17th top eight.
Wow.
And here he'll be playing in the finals. This is the first time he's played in the finals in the three trips to Denver. He's fallen just short a couple of times.
Do we know what the other list is he'll be playing against?
I watched John Grasser play earlier today. Miranda and two gold. Yeah, he's the reason I have gold one and gold two stickies.
Okay. Well, that should be an interesting matchup because Miranda versus Miranda.
Yep. So we have dials down, it appears, for three of the four ships. We don't have a Jess dial, it doesn't look like yet.
Yeah, being that she ended up pretty much parallel with Corrin, this is a difficult move for her. It's not... There's really no good moves.
Are you thinking about a block here? A right side bank?
You're thinking about either a block or... Well, it looks like she's doing one forward.
Or you're going one forward.
Right.
That's a one forward from Jess, and maybe that's a blocking maneuver.
The only way that blocks is any kind of... I don't even think it's going to block the one slight to the left. So...
It's a one straight from Cornhorn. Yep. Happy to just hang out next to Jess here as time's coming close to expiring. Corrin would get a shield back, but it doesn't matter because he doesn't take any damage.
Doesn't need it. No, that one forward by Corrin, I think, is good because I don't think that Kyle is going to anticipate that. And he's going to try a longer move with Poe and get bumped.
Yep, Poe could run right into Corrin here. Miranda with a bank maneuver to the right, too. Now, I wouldn't slam here. I think you're going to get a shot here.
No, this time, I mean,
and he took
you can shoot at Jess, so you already know where she's going to be. Oh, he did anticipate that. Okay.
He did. Short move by Poe. Poe's in the six of Corrin, but last turn Poe got four red dice and Corrin took no damage.
All right, I'm going to go on record that Poe is actually going to get one through. We'll see, though.
Spends the evade. Cornhorn takes no damage,
gosh.
Folks.
Oh, my gosh.
Cornhorn.
Oh, he used up his target lock. That's...
Yep.
Cornhorn takes no damage. Is that TLT on Jess?
I think that is a TLT, but I think it was on Poe. Kyle will confirm that for us and take a shield off somebody. It was Jess. Jess lost a hull.
Push one more through and she's gone.
Integrated astromech, though.
Oh, you're right. Integrated astromech.
Jess Pava pops the astromech. That means no snapshot anymore, correct?
Because that's correct.
The astromech gave her the ability to take snapshot.
Just like we messed up with our R3A2 before.
So yeah. Jess loses snapshot in that exchange when she ejects her astromech, but she keeps her last hull point. Kyle asking Dan there about the maneuver dial on the E-Wing. Corrinhorn does not have one hard turns. That is not something E-Wings do.
And unfortunately, if you don't know the dial and you really want to go for the block, it really telegraphs that you're trying for the block here.
So we've got some dials down. We've got templates and tokens scattered everywhere. I can barely tell what's going on at this point. But it's 13 hours into this day of X-Wing.
And these are really tall tables. And as opposed to the short tables, it's harder to reach across the table to get your tokens off. So that may be a little of it.
Yes. The chat channel says we keep the EPT, even though the astromech gave the ability to get the EPT.
Oh, right. Unlike Nian Num, where you burn the astromech that's giving you the ability, Just Pava's astromech just allowed you to have the EPT on her.
So she still gets to keep it.
Right, and when the astromech goes, sorry, you still have that EPT. You really can't get anything by the chat. They always come up with the right answer.
Yep. Hey, that's fine. I don't mind crowdsourcing the right answer. A focus token there after Miranda's move.
I can't
see. The judge has called time in the room.
Okay.
This is the last round. Corrinhorn with a hard two. That one is on the dial, and that one was blocked by Kyle.
Okay. The problem is, Poe is so close. I don't know that he has a maneuver that doesn't get blocked that will get shots.
He's trying a one bank.
So.
And that doesn't get Corrin an arc. Focus token on Poe.
They may shake hands here, or they may go through with the Miranda shots.
Yep, there you go. So Kyle picks up Jess Pava. Daniel Harz is through to the finals. Corrinhorn and Miranda will face John Grasser. Broomfield, Colorado, Dan plays right here against Albuquerque, New Mexico, where John Grasser has headed up I-25 to visit with us today. I'm John Stevens. Joining me this round, Alex Vienter. Thank you very much, Alex.
Thanks for having me. I hope I wasn't an embarrassment to SoCal.
I hope you weren't as well. I had a lot of fun doing this. We are going to step away for about 10 minutes while we set up the finals. Daniel Harz, John Grasser, live from Broomfield, Colorado. We'll see you in 10.